problem spots. And it's something that Matt Lopez with TechStar iterated this morning. He said that Denton County, Collin County, Parker County, even the Decatur area were pre-treated for the icy conditions. But unfortunately, Dallas County and Tarrant County were not, because the rain and the precipitation wasn't expected to go as far south, but it did. And that's why we have so many issues. So breaking it down for you, I-20 and Southfield were definitely the biggest concern right now. That's an area where TxDOT has not quite reached. And unfortunately, we've got about a half dozen accidents spread between South Fort Worth and the Arlington area, including this one on I-20 westbound at Green Oaks. We've also got 35W north and south closed at Wilshire in the Burleson area. We've got ice on 360 northbound at I-20 through the Arlington area. And in Dallas County, ice in North Dallas on 635 at 35E and at the High 5. And in southern Dallas County, we've got some major problem spots as well, all along I-20 from Duncanville all the way towards the 35E and I-45 interchange. Let's talk to Jeff Rado about that forecast.
Let me show you why the problems are spreading across now North Dallas County, headed towards Mesquite and Segoville. Heads up, we've got some freezing drizzle, heavy enough to show up on radar in this darker color. It's been moving down the 20 corridor, creating all sorts of icing problems on the bridges.
They didn't get into Jason.
And now it is moving just into the southeast corner of Dallas County and into Kaufman County. So heads up, Terrell and Kaufman, this is headed your way and creating problems as it comes over you, because it is freezing drizzle, and on the bridges and overpasses with temperatures below freezing, we're getting into these problems. It won't be a problem later this afternoon.